Hi students, welcome you all to this session. In the previous session we discussed regarding the new chapter psychometric processes and psychometric properties. In the previous session we discussed regarding the important psychometric properties and the psychometric processes. So among them we discussed four psychometric processes. One is sensible cooling, second one is sensible heating, humidification and dehumidification. So today we are going to discuss regarding the remaining psychometric processes. So these psychometric processes are combination of the above four psychometric processes. First one is cooling with dehumidification. So here along with sensible cooling we are going to dehumidify the air. That means we are going to remove the moisture content present in the atmospheric air. So this is the arrangement. This is the cooling coil. This cooling coil surface area is larger than sensible cooling coil surface area. That means, so when the cooling coil surface temperature is less than the dew point temperature of the air at corresponding pressure, so then condensation starts. So this is the air coming from here. From here to here, air is going to cool. So later part further, it is going to condense. So here at state point 2, at this cross section the air is cooled and dehumidified. So this is the arrangement and this is the psychometric chart. You can see here, first this is state point 1. So air is coming in into this cavity. Initial relative humidity is 80%. So initially sensible cooling happens from state point 1 to this X state point. So then after further we are going to pass the air through this cooling coil from here to here. So condensation takes place. So then temperature also decreases along with dehumidification takes place. This is the state point 2. So let us say the initial state point temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, then final state point temperature is 14 degrees Celsius. So now here we can balance the mass and energy. So first we can balance the mass of dry air. So mass of dry air coming in must be equal to mass of dry air going out, because there is no change in the mass of the dry air, but only moisture content is going to vary. So now let us balance the mass of water. So mass of water coming in is equal to m dot a1 into specific humidity of state point 1. So we are going to get mass of water vapor coming into this cavity. So dotted indicates the control volume. This is equal to mass of water vapor going out at state point 2, that is m dot a2 into omega 2, that is specific humidity at state point 2, plus some mass of water is condensed, that is m dot w. So this is the mass balance of water vapor. From this we can get m dot w is equals to m dot a into so omega 1 minus omega 2. So this we can find out. So mass of water condensed we can find out from this equation. Similarly energy balance. So energy coming in must be equal to energy going out. So energy coming in from this air, that is, so summation of energy coming in is equals to Q out. To cool this air we need to extract some amount of heat energy, that is Q out. So Q out we are going to extract, plus sum of energy, summation of energy which is going out through the air. So from this what we can write, so Q out, that is heat energy going out through this cooling coil by absorbing the heat energy from the air, is equals to, so mass of energy, that means amount of energy coming in through this air, that is equals to m dot into h1, m dot into h1 is coming in, minus m dot into h2, amount of heat energy going out, minus some amount of heat energy is going out through the condensate, that is equals to minus m dot w into hw. So minus sign indicates going out, plus sign indicates coming in. So from this we can calculate the amount of heat energy which is carried away from the cooling coil. So From this we can calculate, so amount of water removed is equals to change in specific humidity. So omega 1 minus omega 2 kg of vapor per kg of dry air we are going to get. Similarly, heat energy removed per kg of dry air. So same equation if you divide throughout by m dot, we are going to get m dot A into H2 minus H1 minus, so m dot W into HW per kg of dry air. So these equations we can get. So this is regarding cooling with dehumidification. So this is small correction. This is actually H1 minus H2. So these two we can calculate from these equations. Okay, next sixth process is cooling and humidification. Along with sensible cooling, we need to humidify. During this process, moisture content of the air increases as the moisture is added to the air, and as a result, the RH value increases. That means relative humidity increases with a decrease in dry bulb temperature. You can say this is the process. So 1 to 2 is the process, cooling with humidification. Look at here, this is a specific humidity omega 1 and this is specific humidity omega 2. So specific humidity increases along with cooling effect. So corresponding value we can read from the psychometric chart. So this is the enthalpy of air, HA1 at initial state point, and this is the enthalpy of air at final state point 2 after cooling and humidification. And you can see this is the relative humidity line, this is the RH value 1 and this is RH value at state point 2. So from this it is similar to the cooling with equations are similar to the cooling with the dehumidification. So total amount of heat removed is equals to, so mass of air, mass of dry air into HA1 minus HA2 kilojoules of air. So from this you can calculate total amount of heat energy removed, amount of moisture added here. So here we need to add the moisture content. How to add moisture content? Just by spraying the water into the air stream. So delta omega is equals to ma mass of dry air into specific humidity at state point 2 omega 2 minus specific humidity at state point 1 kg of moisture content. So this is the second equation. And similarly, the capacity of cooling coil in tons of refrigeration is given by, in order to express in terms of tons of refrigeration, we need to divide by 3.5 to this equation. So we are going to get in terms of tons of refrigeration. So these are the equation used in case of cooling and humidification. Arrangement is very simple. Along with the cooling coil, we have to spray the water. That is the arrangement. So this is the sixth process. And the next seventh process is heating and humidification. So here we are going to heat, sensible heat, and then we are going to add the moisture content. So this is the arrangement you can see here. This is the heating coil. So red color indicates the heating coil. So this is state point 1 where air enters. So you can see in the psychometric chart, the air's relative humidity is 30% and 10 degrees Celsius. We need to heat this air by using the heating coil from state point 1 to state point 2. We are not altering here specific humidity. So specific humidity omega 2 must be same as specific humidity at state point 1. We are not altering the specific humidity, just we are going to heat. We are going to increase the temperature of air from 10 degrees Celsius to 22 degrees Celsius. This is just for the example, for the reference. We can heat up to any temperature itself. Okay. Next, we are going to add the moisture content from the humidifier. So from state point 2 to 3, we are going to add the moisture content. That means we are going to spray the water. So as a result, temperature also increases, because whenever we spray the water whose temperature is more than the state point 2, so then temperature also increases along with, so water content is also going to increases. So specific humidity here at state point 3 must be more than specific humidity at state point 2. So this psychometric chart you can see here. So temperature increases from 22 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius. Along with that, moisture content is also going to increases. So this is the setup. So now, as usual, so we are going to apply the conservation of mass and conservation of energy principles to the air and water. So upon applying the conservation of mass to the dry air, so dry air mass content is remains the same. So mass flow rate of dry air at state point 1 must be equal to m dot a2 mass flow rate of dry air is equals to mass flow rate of dry air at state point 3. Dry air we are not going to alter. So now conservation of water, so omega 1 is equals to omega 2. That means we are not adding or removing the moisture content here, but from here to here we are going to add the moisture content. That is, so m dot a2 into w2, so that is moisture content present at state point 2, plus we are going to add the mass flow rate of water here, that is amount of moisture content added, mass flow rate of water, that is equals to, so total moisture content coming out from the state point 3, that is m dot a3 into omega 3. So this is by the conservation of mass for water. Next, apply the conservation of energy. So heat coming in must be equal to heat going out. So here we are going to add heat energy. Hence, heat energy goes from heating coil to air. So that is Q dot plus. So energy carried away from the air at state point 1 is equals to m dot a1 into whose enthalpy h1. That is equals to energy goes out. That is m dot a2 into h2. So these three equations we can write. So from these equations further we can write these two equations. Amount of water added is equals to, so change in specific humidity delta omega, that is equals to omega 3 minus omega 2. Omega 3 minus omega 2 is the amount of water added. So that gives in terms of kg of water vapor per kg of dry air. So if I divide throughout to this equation by m dot a, then we are going to get this equation. Similarly, heat added per kg of dry air, we can write this equation. So m dot a1 into h2 minus h1 kilojoules per second of dry air. So this equation we can write. This is for heating and humidification process. And the next eighth process is heating and dehumidification. So along with heating, we need to dehumidify. That means we need to remove the moisture content. So look at it, this is the state point 1. So where enthalpy is HA1, and we need to heat this one. So dry bulb temperature increases. So along with the decreasing moisture content. So you can see omega 1 is more than omega 2. So this is the HA2, enthalpy of final state point of air. So as a result, relative humidity also going to decrease. RH1 is more than RH2. So during this process, specific humidity decreases as the moisture being removed from the air, and enthalpy of the air increases as well as the dry bulb temperature. Enthalpy also increases as well as dry bulb temperature. So this is the eighth process, heating and dehumidification. So arrangement is simple. So we need to heat initially. Heating coil has to be put into the cavity. So along with that, we have to put the cooling coil also. That means to condense the fluid, to condense the water. So amount of water removed is equals to delta omega, that is equals to omega 3 minus omega 2. So this is actually omega 2 minus omega 1, a small as now it becomes right. Amount of water removed is equals to delta omega is equals to omega 1 minus omega 2. That gives kg of vapor removed per kg of dry air, and heat added is equals to q dot is equals to, so m dot a1 into h2 minus h1. So enthalpy of air at outlet at state point 2 minus enthalpy of air at inlet h1. So this gives in terms of kilojoules per second of dry air. So this equation we wrote from by applying the conservation of mass for water, and this equation we got from by applying conservation of energy to the air. So this is the eighth process. Okay, next important process is adiabatic saturation process. This is a setup, adiabatic saturator. It is called as adiabatic saturator. So where here at state point one we are sending the air. So air is passes over the liquid water here. As a result, it is going to absorb some amount of water content from the liquid water from here. So water vapor is going to add here, and finally, so as a result, as the liquid water is added to the air, whose temperature is going to decreases, and at state point two, cold air is comes out. But the thing is, this air is 100% saturated. So this is the general setup of adiabatic saturator. It is also called as evaporative cooler. So here mass of liquid water is decreased here as a result of absorbed from the air, so that makeup water is sent from this pipe. So this is a setup. So T1 is the temperature at state point 1, omega 1 means specific humidity at state point 1, and pi 1 means relative humidity at state point 1, and corresponding values, these are the corresponding values at state point 2. So T2 is less than the T1, specific humidity increases and relative humidity also increases. So this is the adiabatic saturator, and this is the process in the TS diagram. So this initial state point, so this is the final state point. So dotted end indicates, so here temperature of air decreases not less than the dew point temperature. Okay, so temperature decreases how much? More than the dew point temperature at a corresponding pressure. So that we can tell from the conservation of mass for air. So mass remains the same for dry air. So dry air mass is not going to vary here. We are going to add the moisture content. So this is the conservation of mass for the air. So this is conservation of mass for water. So mass of water content coming from this air, that is m dot w1 plus mass of water is added here, that is m dot f is equals to mass of water goes out, m dot w2. And this can also we can write like this. So m dot w1 is equals to m dot a into specific humidity omega 1 plus m dot f, this is equals to, this we can write m dot a into omega 2. From this equation we can find out, so amount of mass of water added, that is m dot f is equals to, so by simplifying this equation we are going to get m dot a into omega 2 minus omega 1. So this is from conservation of mass of water. Similarly, by applying the conservation of energy to this adiabatic saturator, so energy in must be equal to energy out. From this we can write, so energy coming in from the air, that is equals to m dot a into h1 plus, so energy is coming in from the liquid water, that is m dot f into hf2 is equals to energy goes out, that is m dot a into h2 we can write. So from this, so we can write this equation. So this m dot from this equation, so m dot f from this we are going to substitute here. As a result, we are going to get, so this equation, by substituting m dot f value to this equation, we can get this equation. And from this, divide throughout from the m dot, we are going to get this equation. And this equation further we can write, so where h1 is equals to enthalpy of dry air, so that is equals to Cp into T1 enthalpy at the supersaturation plus, so omega 1 into Hg1 means enthalpy at the liquid level, plus this equation is equals to H2 means Cp into T2 plus omega 2 into Hg2. So this is the heat in the vapor region. So it is the heat in wet region. From this equation we can derive the omega 1 like this, where omega 2 specific humidity at state point 2 is unknown, that can be found out from this equation. So this equation we already discussed in the previous, that means properties. So where Pg2 and P2 indicates. So PG2 means partial pressure of dry air, and P2 means total pressure of dry air at state point 2. The specific humidity and relative humidity of air can be determined from above these equations by measuring pressure and temperature of air at inlet and exit of the adiabatic saturator. So from this we can derive these equations. So this is one of the application of adiabatic saturation process, that is evaporative cooler. You can see this is the mud jug. So if you fill the water, this temperature of water is going to decrease after some time as a result of evaporative cooling. Okay, this is also, you can see evaporative coolers you might have seen in the home appliances. So we are going to spray the cold and chilled air. As a result, we are going to get the cold moist air at the outlet of evaporative coolers. So next to one topic is adiabatic mixing of two air streams. So this is commonly we are using in the ACs, air conditioning systems. So where cold air is coming from one side and hot air is going from another side. So those two are mixing with each other, and then final product we are going to send to the living area. So this generally happens in the air conditioning system. Many AC applicants require the mixing of two air streams. So this is particularly true for large buildings, most production and process plants and hospitals, which require that the conditioned air be mixed with a certain fraction of fresh outside air, so before it is going to route it into the living space. So this is the adiabatic mixing of two air streams. So this is the arrangement, simple setup. And here now we can do the conservation of mass and energy for the air and water. For dry air, so mass of dry air at section 1 plus mass of dry air at section 2 is equals to mass of dry air at section 3. So this mass of dry air plus this mass of dry air is equals to, so going out mass of dry air. Similarly for water, so mass of water coming from this section 1 is equals to specific humidity into mass of dry air plus this mass of dry air, water vapor coming from section 2, a second pipe, is equals to omega 2 into m dot a2. This is equals to, so mass of water goes out from the section 3 at pipe 3, that is specific humidity omega 3 into m dot a3. So this equation you can write. So similarly from energy equation, conservation of energy equation, so energy coming in must be equal to energy goes out. Energy coming in from here and here plus energy goes out from here, that we can write. So m dot a1 into h1 plus m dot a2 into h2 is equals to m dot a3 into h3, that we can write. And this is the corresponding psychometric processes. This is state point 1, cold air coming from here, and this is state point 2, hot air coming from here. These two are mixed with each other, and that state point is 3 here. Okay, so from this we can directly write the equations. So these equations we can write, m dot a1 divided by m dot a2 is equals to omega 2 minus omega 3 divided by omega 3 minus omega 1. So this we can also write h2 minus h3 divided by h3 minus h1. And also, so this temperature, dry bulb temperature at state point 3 can be calculated from this equation, that is equals to m dot a1 plus TdB. TdB means dry bulb temperature at state point 1 plus m dot a2 into dry bulb temperature at state point 2 divided by m dot a3 at dry bulb temperature. In this section, m dot a3. So from this we are going to calculate what is the dry bulb temperature at section 3. So this is regarding adiabatic mixing of air streams. Remember, this usually occurred in the air conditioning systems. So these equations we are going to use. And the next one is cooling towers. So generally cooling towers are used in the thermal power plants to cool the condensate which is coming from the condenser, or it is also called as coolant. So this is the setup of a cooling tower. So next in the next slide I am going to show the actual picture of cooling tower. So this is the pictorial representation. So this is the exhaust fan fitted over the top of the cooling tower, and in sometimes fans are fitted here also at the bottom to push the air. And here we are going to spray the warm water. You can see here warm water is coming from the condenser, so that warm water is going to spray from the nozzles here. So at the side of the walls of the cooling tower, so atmospheric air is blown, it is sucked from the exhaust fan. So here this water spray and this air is going to mix with each other. As a result, so some amount of heat energy is going to extract from this water vapor to the this air. This air is going to extract the amount of heat from the water vapor, and hot air is blown out from this cooling tower. So as a result, so water becomes chilled, cooled. That cooled water is going to stay here. So this is the collected, and then further after cooling it is sent back to the condenser. So this is the cooling tower arrangement. So masked air principles also apply the role in the analysis of cooling tower, such as shown in the figure, this figure. So major events occurring within the control volume enclosed in the tower included the following. This control volume indicates, so most of the applications are going to take place here. Here we are going to send the warm water. Same thing is explained here, what I told, that is going to spray from the nozzles. So heat energy extracted from the air, atmospheric air. As a result, this water becomes cold, that is collected here. So this cold water is sent back to the condenser. So now we are going to analyze the we do the analysis of the cooling tower energy balance and mass balance. So here mass of water sprayed here not same as the mass of water collected here. So some amount of water content is going to evaporate by using the air. It is going to extract from the air. So to compensate that air, mass of water, we are going to add some makeup water here. We are going to add some makeup amount of water. So now, so let us balance the air first, mass of air. So mass of air coming from here, dry air, must be equal to mass of dry air goes out from here, m dot a4. Now we are going to balance the water, mass of water. So mass of water m dot w1 coming from here is coming in, plus makeup water is coming in m dot 5, plus some amount of water vapor is also comes from the atmospheric air, that is m dot v3 is equals to, so mass of water goes out. So mass of water goes out from here to the condenser, that is the m dot w2, plus some amount of mass of water goes out from the exhaust air, that is m dot v3. And already I told, so this mass of water coming in must be equal to mass of water going out to the condenser. There should not be any changes. Hence this and this get cancels. So from this we can write, so makeup water added, makeup water added m dot 5 is equals to, so mass of water vapor goes out through the exhaust minus mass of water vapor comes in from the atmospheric air. This equation we can write from the conservation of mass principle applied to the water vapor. And from this we can also write, so m dot v3, mass of water vapor coming in from the atmospheric air, is equals to omega 3 into m dot a. This we can write. And similarly we can write m dot v4 is equals to specific humidity omega 4 into m dot a. That we can write, that already we are writing from the beginning, where m dot a is a common. Hence we can divide throughout by the m dot a, then we can write, so this equation becomes m dot 5 is equals to m dot a mass of dry air into specific humidity omega 4 at outlet exhaust air minus omega 3. This we can write. So next, energy balance. So apply the conservation of energy principle to this control volume, to this cooling tower. So then we can write, so energy comes in, one is energy is coming in from the warm water, that is m dot mass flow rate of water at inlet plus enthalpy of water h1, this is comes in plus. So air is comes in here, whose energy, that is m dot a3 into h3 plus makeup water is coming in here, whose energy, that is m dot w at state point 5 into h5. This is equals to energy goes out. So energy is going out here in the two forms, one is through the coolant, cooling water, another is through the exhaust air, that is m dot w2 into h2, that is energy goes out through the coolant plus energy goes out through the exhaust, that is m dot a4 into h4. So this equation we can write, that is from the energy balance. You can see these are the actual diagrams of cooling towers. They are very bigger. So these are the cooling towers, and similar example is shown here. And this is the schematic diagram of a coal power station. You can see here we are going to send the coal. Here coal is burned, so water is coming from the condenser through the pump. That is going to convert into vapor here. That vapor is we are going to send into the steam turbine, where steam is going to expand and it converts the work energy. So that work is coupled to the generator to generate electricity. So generated electricity can be transferred to the grid through this transformer and lines. And vapor steam comes out from the low pressure, low temperature steam comes out from the turbine, that is goes to the condenser, where it is condensed to the liquid form by the help of coolant. That coolant is come from the cooling tower. So chilled water is coming from here, from the cooling tower. So it absorbs the, this cooling coolant is going to absorb the heat energy present in the vapor, and it becomes warm and it is goes to the cooling tower. So as a result, steam is going to condense into liquid, and that liquid is sent back to the boiler. And here some amount of moisture content is going to escape to the atmosphere. That can be compensated from makeup water, that is generally extracted from the lake or reservoirs. So this is the thermal power plant or coal power station schematic diagram. So these are the things we discussed today. One is cooling with humidification, cooling with dehumidification, heating with humidification, heating with dehumidification, adiabatic evaporative process, saturation process, and evaporative cooling, that we discussed. And finally, we discussed regarding the adiabatic mixing of two air streams and cooling towers. Okay, thank you. In the next video, I am going to explain regarding the air conditioning systems. There are 4 air conditioning systems are there. So those things we are going to discuss in the next class. Thank you, Nandal. If you have any doubts, you can contact me.